Now, in this video, we are going to find the resultant of two forces, F1 and F2. Now, the first thing we need to remember is that a force is a vector. Now, if it's a vector, it's either given by the magnitude and direction, like here, for example. Like here, for example, this force F1 has a magnitude of 100 Newton, and it makes an angle of 30 degrees with the x-axis. Now, we can also define forces or vectors in general by their components. So let's go here and look at the basics of what are the components. So this is my vector V, which can be a force or any vector. It has a magnitude. Now, this is the notation for magnitude of V. And then let's suppose it makes an angle theta with the x-axis. So we can say that this vector V, it's either has got a magnitude of V, and it makes an angle of theta with the x-axis, or we can also define it by its component. The components are defined as follows. This is the V along x, and this is the V along y. So we call them x component and y component. Now, what is the relationship between theta, Vx, Vy, and the magnitude? Very simple. Let's use the basic trigonometry. And remember, the cosine of theta is equal to the adjacent side. So this is my theta. This is the adjacent side. Vx divided by the hypotenuse. Now, the hypotenuse is the magnitude of V. So, using this, we can say that Vx, the component Vx, is equal to the cosine of theta multiplied by the magnitude of V. Now, the sine of theta. Again, using the definition of the sine is the opposite side, Vy. Vy. Divided by the magnitude of V, and this gives me that the component Vy is equal to sine of theta multiplied by the magnitude of V. So it's a multiplication here. Good. Now let's go and use this idea to F1 and F2. Okay, so let's now say is to find the component of the resultant force, Fr. Now, we first need to find the component of F1 and F2. So F1 is given by the magnitude of F1 is given as 100 newtons. The angle it makes with the x-axis, let's call it theta, is equal to 30 degrees. This is given. So we're going to go here and find the two components, F1 along x and F1 along Y. Now, let's look at the formula here. What did we say? Vx, the component along X, F1x is equal to cosine theta multiplied by the magnitude. The magnitude is here 100. F1y, it's sine theta multiplied by 100 magnitude. Good. Now, so this is 1 F1, number 2 F2, the magnitude of F2. The magnitude of F2 is equal to 150. It's given here, 150 newtons. Now, we have got to be careful with the angle theta now, yeah? Remember, the angle we need is the angle between the x-axis and the force F2. So if we look here, it's 30 plus 80. So angle theta is 30 plus 80, and that gives you 110 degrees. So now let's find the component of F2. Let's call them F2x and F2y along the x-axis, along the y-axis. So here it will be the cosine of 110 degrees, cosine theta, multiplied by the magnitude 150. Here it will be the sine of 110 degrees multiplied by the magnitude. Good. Now, let's call FRX the x component of the resultant, FR, and FRY the y component. Now, remember FR is F1 plus F2. So when it comes to the component, you just add F1X plus F2X, and then F1Y plus F2Y. All this comes from the operations on vectors. Now this, we just go and substitute F1X. F1X is cosine 30 degrees multiplied by 100 plus F2X. F2X is here. Cosine 110 degrees multiplied by 150. Now F1Y is here. So it's sine of 30 degrees multiplied by 100 plus the sine of 110 degrees multiplied by 150. Now, using the calculator, these two components are given by FRX is 35.30. FRY is 190.95. Now, let's put all this here. So, the component of the resultant, we call them FRX, approximately equal 35.30, and FRY approximately 190.95. So part A, we finish with part A. Now let's go to part B. In part B, they ask us, the question is to find the magnitude of FR. Now this is very simple, it's just the square root of FRX squared plus FRY squared, which are here and here. So we just substitute, we use a calculator, and we find 194.19, and the unit is a newton, this is the magnitude. So 194.19 newton. Now, what we have done, we have added F1 and F2, the two vectors, to obtain FR. So, remember to add two vectors, what you do, you keep one, F1, for example, and you draw a parallel to F2, to the second vector, for example, like this. You just draw a line or a vector from here to here, and this is your FR, the vector sum of F1 and F2. Now, and this vector, of course, it has the component which we found already. So this is FRX, and it has got the component FRY. Good. The next question is part C, is to find the angle between the x-axis and the resultant. Let's call it alpha. But before we do, we find alpha, let's review some basic ideas. When you have a vector V, now knowing the component Vx and Vy, but let's do some trigonometry here. Remember, the tangent of theta is equal to the opposite side. So the tangent of theta is equal to the opposite side Vy. Vy divided by Vx, and therefore theta is the tangent inverse, remember, of Vy over Vx. So this is exactly what we are going to use to find this angle, because we know the component of Fr. So alpha, which is the angle, which, now let's define it first, is the angle between the x-axis and our resultant fr. So this alpha is given by the tangent inverse of fry divided by frx. Now substitute the values that we found for the components here, and so that will be tangent inverse fry 190.95 frx 35.30, and using a calculator this approximately gives an angle of 39.53 degrees. Okay, so this is part C, the angle, part B, the magnitude, and part A, the component. Here we have answered all the questions. Now the most important thing to remember from this video is writing the component of vectors. So going from magnitude direction into components, or from components to magnitude and direction. These are the most important things.